we're talking about that stuff with Facebook, one of the things that you can do with Facebook is you create a Facebook page for your class. So that's one thing that I would definitely recommend. That way you keep your personal stuff separate from your classroom stuff. So if people want to friend you on your classroom page, all they friend is your classroom page. They cannot see anything on your personal Facebook account. And I would definitely recommend that. Because even if they Google you up and pull up your personal account, if you have all of your security settings in Facebook locked to where nobody can see it but your friends, then they won't be able to see anything. Now, one caveat to that, and I know I'm going to tangent here a little bit on Facebook, but one of the caveats is in Facebook, the way the Facebook is set up, let's say you and I are shared, and you and I are friends. I can have everything locked down on my side of the house, but if your account is open, whatever I'm sharing with you is being slowly trickled out, leaked out to everybody else that other person is connected to. So that's why I always tell people, if you share something that is really personal, tell the person you're sharing it to, please do not share it with anybody else. I'm sharing this with you because I just want you to see it, not the whole of Facebook and all of your friends and your friends to see it. And if that person doesn't abide, me personally, I will not be friends with that person because they're not trying to protect my privacy.
Right, but you should also, even on your own page, you should be smart about what you put.
Oh, most definitely, yeah, because that's your digital fingerprint. That's what people see, and that's what they're going to remember you for, and it's there. Once you put it there,